Being a pilot is the best because there are no rules. Sorry, there are heaps of rules. There's just no one to check on them. You can't get pulled over in the sky. No one has ever checked my license. No one has ever breathalyzed me. No one has ever drug tested me. There's a key to the door that opens our hangars, and then the planes don't even have keys. If you can fly them, you can take them. The reason I'm telling you this is because if there's a story on the news 5 years from now and I'm accused of smuggling drugs around this beautiful country and I'm on the news going, I didn't do it. There's no way I'd ever do this. I did it.
Let's welcome Tommy Little. Yeah.
Hello, gang. Very nice to be here.
Great to have you, but they let that guy write a kid's book?
Yes.
Why?
Well, to be honest, I wrote this during one of our 40,000 lockdowns that we were under. And I had a girlfriend at the time and I thought we were potentially going to start a family. Yeah. And so I had this idea for a kid's book and I wrote it. And the relationship didn't work out.
But the book did.
But the book did. I'd already finished the book and so I submitted it and we got it illustrated. And, yeah, here we are.
So it's called Who Took My Nuts?
Yes. And it is about a young boy who's lost his testicles. No, it is about, obviously, squirrels and a greedy, mean squirrel. There was a few issues over the name of the book because originally it was going to be called Don't Touch My Nuts. Which I thought was the message we want to encourage children to say. Yes. And so I said, I'll change the title and it can be called Touch My Nuts. And they said, no, we're going... Anyway, so anyway, we set it on Who Took My Nuts. And it's been so fun to write. I get to... Because I fashioned it about the kid that I hadn't had yet and I thought this would be a great thing to make for them. And then, of course, when that didn't work out, I started just writing it with my nieces in mind. So the main character is a cute little girl squirrel who wears glasses, like one of my little nieces, and, yeah, it's fun.
Can we just go to that gorgeous dedication at the start of the book? It's lovely. I want to show everyone at home. To the kid I haven't had yet, I can't wait till a lifetime of trying to make you laugh and smile. That had girls in the office in tears. Are you settling down?
Well, I'm available because, as I said, my relationship didn't work out.
That was 2 years ago. You could have redone the dedication.
I could have redone it, but I hope it gets me a girlfriend.
Tommy, I'm more worried. Yes. You're a great-looking man and hilarious one to be.
Thank you. I wish I could say the same.
I know. All right. Yeah. What I'm worried about, the amount of dates you've been on, are you sure you don't already have a kid?
I haven't done the research, but Father's Day is a nervous 24. But we're here for a kid's book. Yeah. You guys looking around. Is that question's done?
Would 7-year-old Tommy have gotten around this book, do you reckon?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
I think it's... I would have gotten around it just for the title, which took my nuts off funny. But, yes, it's got, like... I mean, this will sound like I'm being too earnest, but someone wrote on... I get abused online all the time because... but someone wrote a comment on my thing and said, oh, grow up. And I found it very funny because I was like, I'm clearly a grown-up. Like, I've got a pilot's licence, I own a property, I have a company. And so I wrote back and I said, oh, I'm grown up. I think the word you're looking for is immature. Like, calling someone that is an adult and telling them to grow more is ridiculous. And so I think you were looking for immature. And the great thing about being able to write a kid's book is immaturity for me is the best. Yes. And suddenly I've got an audience who I know none of them are both grown up or
mature.
They're all mature.
It's kind of like writing for a peer group in a way, isn't it?
Yes, exactly. Yeah. So it's great. It's fun to get lost in that world.
Yeah.
This upsets me a little bit, Tommy. I've got two beautiful boys at home. I am a parent. As someone with no children, is writing a kid's book cultural appropriation?
Yeah, it's great.
Excellent question.
It is actually, Cody, it is a great question, but you are a rather absent father, so...
That's why I'm here. I hate bath time.
No, I feel like I just get... you would know reading to your kids would be one of the great joys of doing it.
Of course.
And so I get to kind of write a book that hopefully makes your life easier. And I also get one of the great joys of parenthood without all the miseries that you constantly complain to me about.
Tommy, yes. Now, speaking of things that are nuts, yes. I saw this video of you recently. I think we've got it here. Can you walk us through... Oh. Now, this is Tim Zhu, Australian boxing, super middleweight boxing champion. Now, oh, look at that. Oh.
Yeah, this is where it gets bad.
That's
this,
what parenting yeah. is like, you yeah. know?
Oh!
Now, oh! As you can see, yeah. took it like a man.
Oh, look at you.
So you got it slightly wrong, Taunce, because that is Tim Zhu. Yeah. But Tim Zhu is the current world champ. Yeah. And I did two lessons of boxer size thought I'm ready for the ring, but only if I get my superfood. And at the time, I decided it was kebabs. And because I'm a very much respected member of the showbiz community, I decided to also dress as a kebab. And it might not have looked like much, that shot, but it broke my ribs.
Did he?
Really?
And feel this, Sam. You'll have to describe it. Feel that. That's where it's healed. See that lump?
Oh, yeah. I mean, it still feels broken.
Yeah, because the ribs were broken and now they've calcified in that position.
Oh.
And so I need you to buy my kids book to get the surgery that I need to fix me body.
There it is. It's out now. Would you please thank Tommy Leno?
Thank you.